Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Prashant Mehta. I'm working as a consultant in Medical Oncology and I'm also the program director for the Leukemia and Bone Marrow Transplant program in Asian Hospital, Faridabad. Today I wanted to discuss about this important tumor known as the primitive neuroectodermal tumor or PNET, or also commonly known as Ewing Sarcoma. So this tumor, generally this is a type of cancer which affects generally the early teens in both boys and girls, and slightly more common in boys, and it can affect various different parts of the body, especially the hip bone, the hip bones, the pelvis, and also the chest wall, and also the long bones. So this is a type of soft tissue tumor, and also it affects the bones. It can arise from the bones, and it is also very similar to some of the other bone tumors like osteosarcoma. The major difference being that osteosarcoma generally affects the ends of the bones, but Ewing sarcoma, on the other hand, it affects the middle part of the bones. So this kind of a tumor, Ewing sarcoma, is generally diagnosed with a biopsy, and there is a very specific translocation, a genetic mutation, which is found in most patients of Ewing sarcoma. The treatment of Ewing sarcoma is generally done with a combination of chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery. It is a very chemo-responsive tumor, and if it is localized and it has not spread to the beyond the confines of the primary organ of origin, it is generally curable. And once it metastasizes, it becomes difficult to cure. But for a localized Ewing sarcoma or a PNET in children, the treatment generally starts off with chemotherapy, and the chemotherapy is given once in 2 to 3 weeks for about 4 cycles, and thereafter the patient undergoes a surgery, and following the surgery, radiation is also generally required, and after the surgery and the radiation, till about a duration of 1 year, the treatment is continued with chemotherapy. And with this kind of a treatment, most patients with localized Ewing sarcoma can be cured. But if the patient has a metastatic disease, then chemotherapy alone and surgery, a combination of surgery and radiation along with chemotherapy, is generally not able to cure these patients. So some more aggressive and more intensive chemotherapy protocols, and for chemo-responsive disease, even there is a role of bone marrow transplant with high-dose chemotherapy in some patients, and a very well-selected population of some patients who have a metastatic Ewing sarcoma may also be considered for bone marrow transplant, which is autologous bone marrow transplant, and these patients can also achieve cure with such kind of a treatment. So my purpose of discussing this kind of a tumor is that we all as parents need to be aware of these kind of childhood malignancies, and if there is any swelling in any of the bones in the pelvis, any swelling anywhere you find in your child, it is important that you should seek the consultation and help from a doctor and an oncologist, oncologist who can take care of this cancer, and the child can achieve a cure. Thank you.